I'm not sure. We're having technical difficulties, so bear with us. And hopefully we'll get going. But we're starting now just because we are already over time and I don't want you to be guys wait any longer. So, and I've changed the agenda around slightly. New business is going to go right after approval of the minutes. So if you have an agenda, just know that that's taking place. And so I think we need to start with the swearing in of new senators. So, and justices. So I give you Chief Justice Blue.
Here.
Connor Ryan.
Here. Dennis De La Flor.
Here.
Olivia Hingham.
Here.
Daniel Bird.
Here.
Sarah Shane.
Here.
Eliza Conrad. Ian Maxwell. Rebecca Crowley.
Here.
Kara Cassell.
Here.
Shomo Kundu.
Here.
Jay Bravo.
Here.
Nick Franconi. Stephanie Sponzo.
Here.
Connor McNabo.
Here.
Dustin LaVoy.
Here.
Julie Chen. Rachel Conway.
Here.
Oh, up here already.
Chris Delabora.
Here.
All right.
Please. Does anybody happen to have a Windows laptop?
Erica, you want to bring it up here? If you don't mind, volunteering.
All right, we now move into public comment. Is there anybody who would like to be recognized for public comment? Yes. What is your name?
Donna.
Donna, you are so recognized. Come up to the podium.
to be able to bring things up on the screen for you so that you can see them and have an informed vote. Sorry, again, I've got delays.
Driving to three tournaments and will be traveling a combined 4,772 miles purchasing 13 personal vehicles, whereas reimbursement for gas is capped at 55 cents per mile. Whereas the team will require lodging for two of the three tournaments and will need a total of 8 rooms between both to accommodate the team members. Whereas reimbursement for hotel accommodation is capped at $150 per room per night. Whereas they will provide the appropriate receipts to verify the exact amount spent on hotel accommodations. Therefore, be it resolved, the undergraduate student government reimburses the UConn Polo Team $2,624.60 for travel expenses. Be it further resolved, the undergraduate student government reimburses the UConn Water Polo Team $1,292 for lodging expenses. Be it finally resolved, the undergraduate student government reimburses $3,916.60 to the UConn Water Polo Team for travel and lodging expenses.
Is there a motion to enact this act? Motion by Uva, second by Bird. Are there any questions regarding this
language? Can I just make a friendly amendment?
Yes.
When it says UConn Polo, should you say UConn Water Polo?
All right, so if this is a friendly amendment, you can technically amend your own thing right now if you just want to say water polo. By unanimous consent, is it okay with everybody in the room that he amends this legislation so that it reads water polo instead of just polo? By unanimous consent? Wonderful. So, are there any questions regarding this legislation? Is there any debate regarding this legislation? Seeing none. Seeing none, we move into a vote. All those in favor of enacting an act concerning emergency funding for UConn water polo, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, please signify by saying nay. Any abstentions?
Nay.
Clearly passed. We move into an act concerning emergency funding for UConn Airsoft Team. Are there two sponsoring senators?
Yes.
Senator Bravo and Senator Electricon.
Yes. An act concerning funding for the UConn Airsoft Team. Whereas the undergraduate student government is charged with improving the experience of the student body through the funding of undergraduate student initiatives. Whereas the UConn Airsoft Team needs to have off-campus storage as equipment use is prohibited from on-campus housing. Whereas the practice site for UConn Airsoft Team is in East Hampton, Connecticut at Strategic Compound, and Mansfield Storage Self-Storage Facility is the most logical as it is the only one on the way to the practice site from Storage Campus. Whereas the monthly payment is due at the end of each month at a total of $139. Whereas the team is requesting a total of $417 for 3 monthly payments in October, November, and December, and will request funding for the funding process for the spring semester. Whereas this request is Category C and subject to 75% disbursement cut. Therefore, being resolved, the undergraduate student government allocates a total of $317.75 to the UConn Airsoft Team for the storage of their equipment.
Is there a motion to enact this legislation? Senator Bluin and Senator, he gets the motion. Is there a second to this motion? Senator McNamara. Are there any questions regarding this legislation? Also, again, now is the time period. If you think there's something wrong with this, if you want to know more, you are free to ask questions. Don't be scared, even if it's your first Senate. Seeing none, we move into debate. Is there any debate regarding this legislation? Now is the time. If you have a problem with this legislation, you want to amend it, you want to do anything like that, you can do it right now. Senator Sponza, also you come up to the podium, you guys can say that.
I have a question. Senator C.
Yes. Okay. Because this is technically a debate, but because I moved pretty quickly, we'll go back to questions. Senator Bruckler, come on back. We are going back into questions just for, it's the first Senate. We're going to be kind of.
Okay, I was speaking to the
Category C, part of our funded policies. Category C is any request that falls under, like it's not to all students, not available to all students. It's not directly on campus. So in our policies, we whatever money is asked for, 75%. So like category A and B is for 100%, C and D, 75%, and then E is 65%. So it's just part of our funding policy.
Are there any other questions regarding this legislation? Seeing none, we move into debate. Is there any debate regarding this legislation? Seeing none, we move into a vote. All those in favor of enacting an act concerning funding for the UConn Airsoft team, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Say it with some gusto. All those in favor of enacting an act concerning funding for the UConn Airsoft team, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, please signify by saying nay. All those, or any abstentions? Clearly passes. We can clap. All right. And now we move into, sorry, getting the agenda up on the screen for you. Again, not to play this bumpy. I knew of this too. All right, now we move into reports of the executive, President Price.
Officers to we're going to host a program on sexual assault prevention and updates with what UConn has been doing. That's going to be kind of like a workshop, and we are working on that, not just for UHG, that's for everyone, for the whole student body. Pictures for the website are going to take place next week in August. So I think everyone's going to come early at about 6 if you can, if everyone can kind of stagger coming, so that we can still start on time for 6:30. So do your hair and everything, make sure you look good. And finally, we're going to keep this off the list, if you can please Mark reads this, but we're having an awareness event for Mark. Mark is, for those of you who don't know, he is our president, essentially. I'm only the acting president. He's taken the semester off because he was diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma. So on October 12th, from 7 to 9 p.m. on Fairfield Way, it's going to be a fundraiser for the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. And UHG is going to have a table with hot chocolate and cider. But it's going to be really nice. His girlfriend will be there to say a few words. I'll say a few words on behalf of USG just for everything that he's given us. He honestly loves this organization, and he comes to every Senate, but his white blood cell counts were too low for him to come tonight. So definitely reach out to him and just let him know that, you know, he's almost done with chemo, and we're anxiously waiting for his return. That's all. Oh no, that is more. That's all for my report. Now I have to make nominations. So I have to appoint 5 undergraduate students to the University Senate, and I appointed them last Senate, but I have a regional representative who is going to be appointed, who is Hutan Kashi. So I would like to nominate Hutan to serve in the University Senate.
Does the nominee accept their nomination? Yes. I'm assuming yes. Right. Are there any questions regarding this nomination? Yes, Senator Gore.
Which regional?
Which regional?
Yes.
Hartford Campus, for those of you who did not be there. Oh, are there any further questions for this nomination? Seeing none, is there any favor regarding this nomination? Seeing none, we move to a vote. All those in favor of approving the nomination of Hutan Kashi, to University, what committee?
University Senate.
Please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, please signify by saying nay. Any abstentions? Clearly passes.
I'm also appointing a regional representative to the Student Welfare Committee, which Kevin is actually already sitting on, but we are allowed regional reps as well. So he isn't here to accept his nomination. I think Tim can accept on his behalf, but his name is Edison Cornelio.
So,
he accepts.
Are there any questions regarding this nomination? Seeing none, is there any debate regarding this nomination? Seeing none, we move into a vote. All those in favor of approving Edison, what's his last
name? Went on you. I can spell.
All those of approving Edison to the Student Welfare Committee, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, please signify by saying nay. Any abstentions? Confirmed. Yay.
There is a President's Architecture and Environmental Services, I believe, committee, who I'm appointing Kaylee Hines to, who stepped out.
Does the nominee accept?
She accepts.
Are there any questions regarding this nomination? Seeing none, is there any debate regarding this nomination? You are allowed to debate and ask questions. Just so you know. Seeing none, we move into the debate. Are we already in debate? Okay. Seeing none, we move into a vote. All those in favor of approving Kaylee Hines to that committee, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, please signify by saying nay. Any abstentions? Clearly passes.
And that have just been formed as part of Student Affairs. One is the Bystander Intervention Program, and one is the Sexual Assault Education and Prevention Online Program for our division athletes. So I would like to appoint George Wang to the Bystander Intervention Program and Danielle Bergman to the Sexual Assault Education and Prevention Online Program. But I would like to meet with both of you before those meetings start.
Do the nominees accept their nominations?
Yes.
Wonderful. Are there any questions regarding these nominees? Yes, Senator Myers, please come to the microphone. You gotta get in the habit of it. You gotta stand. I'm not a fan of that.
Too much crying.
Yeah, just two quick questions. Are these university committees?
They're not under the University Senate, but yes, they're university committees.
Okay.
Is there anybody else who would like to be recognized for questions? Seeing none, we move into debate. Is there anybody who would like to be recognized for a debate regarding these nominations? No. I'm sorry, So, anybody who would like to be recognized for a debate? Seeing none, we move into a vote. All those in favor of approving these nominees, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, please signify by saying nay. The abstentions, I abstain. Clearly passes. Yay.
Okay, and finally, Rashida Jani, our funding board chair, can't be here tonight. She has an exam from 7 to 9. So I am going to appoint her committee for her. I'm going to do these all together, if that's okay with you. And I apologize in advance if I don't pronounce these correctly, but I'm going to try that. So I would like to nominate to serve on the funding committee Christian Velasco, Leela Liu, Liam Williams, Otis Rackley, Francesca Caruso, Dustin LaVoy, Sam Rogers, Vikram Momak, Hannah Fields, Stephen Coachella, Victor Trofimov, Noman Monfort, Fato Joe, Brett Young, and Tyler Christensen.
Do the nominees accept their nominations?
Yes.
All right. Are there any questions for the nominees? Seeing none, we move to debate. Is there anybody who would like to be recognized for debate regarding these nominations? Seeing none, we move into a vote. All those in favor of enacting or of approving the nominations of the funding board chair, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, please signify by saying nay. Any abstentions? Okay. Yes. Are you abstaining? You guys? No? Okay, good. Totally back. Excellent. Are there any questions for the president?
Yes.
Oh. Chairperson Lim, please go up to the microphone. Yes. You do not have to wave your placard that rigorously. How big that is.
That $150 fee, is that, are there any costs for being able to pay?
No. This was voted on, so this is for the rec center. This was voted on about a year and a half ago, It's going to happen. It will only be implemented once the rec center is usable, the new one. So, but it's all going to be paid for the student fees.
Are there any other questions for the president? Seeing none, we move into the report of the vice president. Vice President Romano. We'll get in the hang of the clapping thing later. I'll tell you in my report.
Welcome to all the new and returning senators. This is going to be a really exciting year. We have some really awesome people, and I can tell it's going to be a great Senate. Just as a side note, there's been like a lot of voting, and I know some of you guys might be new to this. Don't worry about it. I'm sure Kevin will explain it all, and feel free to reach out to him or myself or Claire or really anyone. Anyone is here to help you, and so if you have any questions, just talk to us. The first thing on my report is we're going to be starting a new way of recognizing people as senators and just committee members or anybody in UNSG. And this is going to be done through a kudos form, which will be put online, and it'll be sent out to you, so it's like all online, super easy to fill out. So this is for if you see another senator, a committee member, really anybody who's part of UHG doing exceptional work, going above and beyond. We just want to make sure these people get recognized. So it's super easy, you just fill it out, and the announcements will be made at caucus. And myself and then the membership coordinator, who's Julie Chen, will be sort of running that. If you have any questions, once that comes out, you can ask, but it'll be like pretty self-explanatory in the email. Another thing is that this year we're going to be starting to work on orientation early. So basically sort of coming up with a plan for next year that people can follow in the way to set up orientation, what things need to be covered, so everybody's prepared. So I'm looking for one senator to work with me and Kevin on that. So if someone is interested, just talk to me, email me, or just tell me. So this is going to be sort of setting out basically like a sketch agenda sort of type deal of everything that needs to be included in orientation so we can hand it off to the next people who will be running orientation, so it's more put together. And then one last thing is that we do have those zip-up sweatshirts. We still have a bunch actually left from the time we ordered them. So if you want one, go to the office and ask Dawn for one. She sits like right as you walk in. She's the first one. You'll see her right through the door. She has all of those, and they're $10, so you can literally first come, first serve. If you want one, just go and get it. And then the next thing is, this is part of Justin's report, but we want to do it now. You can pull up an email.
You have the
yeah, okay, so don't click on it. Just scroll down. Okay, so for those of you who are not on the website, please, literally on your phones right now, I know all of you have them, go on your phone and type in that first link. It's really short. He made it super short on purpose, so you can all do it right now. And it gets you to a form where you put your name and like info or whatever if you're not on the website, so that way we can get you into the system, and this way you'll be able to like log in and put your, yeah?
If you already have
it,
we're
still
on this website, should we do it again?
Just make sure your name is either on that form or that your information is on the website, so double check. So this way you'll be able to like update your office hours, put a little bio. Once you get pictures, you can upload that onto there, so it's really useful, so everyone do that. I'll give you a few minutes. Yeah?
With all due respect, Vice President, you are saying I do not own a phone.
All right. Well, we will email that to everyone. Or you can use a computer after, but we'll send it out in an email as well.
But if you want your face to be on the website.
But, okay, so the next thing is if you aren't getting emails from us, from like all these UHG emails, that means you're not on the UHG listserv. Listserv just means like it's a big list of everyone, so it's an easier way to send emails. So if you're not getting emails, go to the second link right there that says listserv and just fill out your name and your email to make sure that you're getting those.
Are there
Yep, and that's it.
Are there any questions for the Vice President? Seeing none, we move into report of the comptroller, I believe, who is not here, so we're going to table that until the end of this meeting. So next is the report of the chief of staff, who is also not here at the moment. So we move into report of the legislative, which is the speaker. Hey, so I have a bit of a longer report than I normally will have because there's a whole heck of a lot that we got to do because it's the beginning of the year. How's everybody doing thus far? You enjoying your first Senate? You get to look very nice. You all look lovely. And so my first, and welcome, obviously. Other people said that. I also welcome you. You're all just delightful. So first, I have some business for nominations committee. We have interviewed two candidates for the remaining two positions on our judiciary. And we have decided to nominate Ari Solomon and Andrew Stern, got it, to the judiciary. So, oh yeah, sorry, I got to turn it off.
Do the nominees accept their nomination?
Yes.
Are there any questions for the speaker? Or about the nominees? You can ask anything. Don't be afraid.
Any questions you want, you can ask me right now about the nominees, not say anything. Yes. Senator Myers, would you like to come to the microphone? I'm a little too excited.
I would just like to ask how the nominees feel like they are capable of upholding this position.
Nominees, would you like to answer? And you can come up here and talk, because there's a microphone. That's very, very fun.
Which one?
This one.
Repeat that question one more time.
Yes, how do you feel that you are capable of upholding this position?
I feel very capable. I have past experience. I came from the West Harker branch. I was vice president of student government there. We actually redid our constitution, which consisted of 25 or 30 pages. It took us 2 to 3 months to actually write it. Had to go through student activities up in stores in order to get it approved. Went through a lot of obstacles to get it done. Made sure we compared the U.S. Constitution to ours, others, the governments that are outside, you know, our rights. So for U.S. I know it's a bigger student government, but I believe that the same policies are up here that were markers. So I'm very good with that stuff. And I'm very passionate for community standards as well. So, yeah. All right. Yeah. Does that answer your question?
I think I would qualify because I interned for law clerks and I took law trial for 3 years. I went to work for cross examination and prosecuting. I think it's important that the judiciary is localized and very, it's a very important branch of government. I'm excited to help the election government hold them.
So for clapping, when typically, when we approve legislation for, say, funding a group, that's when the clapping thing started. It happened last year. Don't really know why, but it's nice, and it feels a little depressing when we don't now. So clap for that. Clap when people are nominated and approved to things, because it's a big thing. But other than that, you don't have to clap for most any other thing. We'll get into a rhythm of it, not a big deal, but just wanted to address that. But so for my report, I just recently, last Friday, spoke with the Student Welfare Committee, which the Vice President for Student Affairs, Dr. Gilbert, sits on that committee. And we talked about a whole host of things from last year and the year before. But the biggest thing is the Student Welfare Committee. It's a university senate committee, and they're very interested in helping us out with whatever we need for our sexual assault prevention efforts. And I know Student Development Committee is actually doing phenomenal work, which you'll hear about in her report. But so if we ever need the administration for this, they are very, very interested in working with us. And there are wonderful people on that committee. And this past week, I brought, as a non-voting member, Stephanie Sponzo along with me. If anybody else is interested in coming along and seeing what the committee is and how it works, you are welcome to just let me know, and I'll bring you along next time they have a meeting. And it's a great learning experience. I've been on that committee. This is my third year. And so it's a really, really good place to be. So just let me know if you have any interest. And also, I'm looking now. I did not send out the email yet because I have been delayed. But there will be a call for letters of intent happening right now for Deputy Speaker. I will send in an email after Senate all of the tenants of Deputy Speaker. I know a couple of you have already spoken with me and sent me letters of intent. Those will be due by this Friday, and I'll be making my selection and nomination by the following the next Senate. And so if you have any questions, again, just come and talk to me. Other than that, I just wanted to say welcome, because you guys actually are really, really enjoyable people, the ones that I've gotten to know, and I look forward to getting to know all of you. And this is the biggest Senate ever, and I'm a strong proponent of size matters, so I think this is going to be, if we're the biggest Senate ever, I think we should be the best Senate ever. You've all been elected in the most competitive elections ever. You have all earned your spot and are expected to represent your constituents. And I know so many of you that I've talked to, you, Stephanie, George Wang, all of the different new senators have all been doing great work thus far already. And so I just encourage you to keep it up. I'm always here to help you and to work with you. Welcome. And I think actually something Claire had mentioned before about Mark Sargent, I think he's a good example of what this organization really means, because he's not only we've worked together since my freshman year, but he's just a wonderful, really, really close friend of all of ours. And I think make those friendships and make those connections with the people in this organization, because they are absolutely some of the best that you'll find at college. And so I just wanted to mention that, because we are a really good group of people, and I think you should all try to get to know each other, mingle after the meeting. It's very fun to talk about things. And so welcome, and yeah. Are there any questions for me? Oh, actually, she asked them.
Are there any questions for the speaker? Ask them anything.
Anything you want this time, you can actually ask me anything you want related to USG.
Great.
Is that it? There's no debate. You don't get the debate. Not now. All right.
One thing I'm going to say, just because I have a mic, put your phones away, please.
Yes.
Up in your pocket. I'm seeing a lot of it. This is a lot of people's first Senate. And if people aren't paying attention to, like, tell about new senators, it's just not worth it. I texted Mark and said hi. But my phone's away now. It's like about 7:30. We don't need to check the time. So please put it on. Thank you.
And I don't have that problem, because I lost my phone last night. So if anybody finds it, it's an iPhone 4. A lot of good stuff on there. Really trying to find it. All right. Now we move into the report of the judiciary. Chief Justice Bluen.
Made notes of all the changes. So
just to make sure that the new one is actually being implemented and that we're not going on the old one. If you guys are interested, and you should probably do this, I look over the new constitution, it's uploaded on the website. I know that we did that at orientation, but for those of you who weren't there, just want to review it again, it's on our website, so that's updated. I'm also currently working with Partha Rashida to try to figure out the judiciary's role in auditing with the funding policies. So basically, the judiciary is going to work with the funding board to make sure that the policies involving equipment or catering, those regulations are being followed. So we'll help them, help maybe go to the events and just check up on them and make sure that everything is good and that they're not violating any of the policies. So we're currently in the works with that. We're just trying to solidify specific responsibilities of the judiciary with that. And then this week, the justices and I are going to sit down and start doing research on the procedures of the Office of Community Standards. For the new senators who don't know about this, I'm looking to form a partnership between the judiciary and the Office of Community Standards by potentially having a student jury or having the judiciary oversee the hearing procedures just to make sure that everything, just to see what the procedures are like and to make sure that the students are involved and we aren't having our voice heard, because I do think that that's an important part where those students should have some say. Hence why we want to form a jury and have some oversight by the judiciary. Finally, the last part of my report is that I'm going to appoint a Deputy Chief Justice. The Deputy Chief Justice basically helps the Chief Justice oversee the actions of the court. So I'm going to appoint Andrew Stern as my Deputy Chief Justice.
Is the nominee accept? Are there any questions regarding this? Actually, wait, pause. You guys don't get to approve this. Never mind. He's good. Sorry, forgot about that. Yeah, we have no power over this. So he's now the Deputy Chief Justice.
And that's the end of my report.
Are there any questions for the Chief Justice? Seeing none, we move into committee reports. The Academic Affairs Committee, Chairperson Tim Lin.
They
I was not able to attend that meeting, but I received good report from Senator Wang about what they were talking about. They talked about advising, basic advising issues were brought up within CLAS. And Dr. Katrina Higgins, Assistant Dean for CLAS, is looking to work with not just CLAS senators, but also the whole USG on certain issues. If you have any concerns regarding advising or anything that goes along with CLAS advising, especially CLAS, please see me or your CLAS senator. So CLAS senators, who are you? Raise your hand. There you go. And that is all.
Are there any questions for Chairperson?
Seeing none, we move into the report of External Affairs, Chairman Kugler.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. In terms of the gubernatorial debate coming up October 2nd, if anybody doesn't know about it yet, it's at 7 p.m. at Jorgensen next Thursday. I believe that tickets are still available. If you go to try to get a ticket, if you haven't gotten one yet and you cannot get one, let me know. I have 4 extras. I think there's some other people who got extras just in case, so let me know. I've been in communication with both campaigns, both Malloy and Foley campaigns. Governor Malloy will be coming to meet with the undergraduate student government, certain members. Unfortunately, space is limited, so if you're interested in attending that meeting, it will be before the debate from 5:45 to 6:15. If you're interested, please send me an email expressing your interest and of the people that are interested and can make it to that time. Depending on how many people ask to be in that meeting, we'll probably end up doing a lottery system for that. I'm still in the process of scheduling a debate with Tom Foley, the Republican candidate. They cannot meet on debate night, but I'll have more information on that coming up when we know when that meeting is scheduled. I've put out a call for letters of intent for the vice chair and national liaison positions to the External Affairs Committee with the due date of Friday, and then I will be conducting interviews next week for those positions. Concord is tabling for voter registration. We decided in committee to kind of coexist with them because there's an initiative on the ballot to approve bonding for the Four Corners Initiative, which is down on Route 195. They want to revitalize that area with water and sewer, and they need a certain threshold of votes to do that. So we're just raising awareness on that issue as Concord does voter registration. Then this past weekend, we had the Celebrate Mansfield Festival. Thank you to everyone, whether you're in External Affairs or not, who came to help out. We had a great response of the 480 little bottles of bubbles that we purchased. We handed out 430 of them to children and adults at times. And we had great participation on our boards, which had what people love about living in a college town. And Christina Rebecca is now helping present some of those things.
So grown-ups wrote some, but we decided that was way less fun for you guys to look at. So we brought the one that the kids did about what they like living in a college town. So we just had a really great response being able to talk to people about what they lived in a college town. So a lot of their parents kind of talked about how the university offered them jobs and housing and different cultural events to attend. And the kids contributed great things, like they like birds. And this one, which they titled Orange Coat. And it was an orange cone, and they were like, no, my favorite part about UConn is orange coat. But overall, we had pretty good discourse, and some people like talked about real things like basketball and the dairy bar and stuff. So it was a really nice way to reach out to the community and, you know, see different people in the town, like local politicians, small business owners. So, yeah.
All right. That concludes my report.
Are there any questions for the chairperson?
Seeing none, we move into a report of, well, normally we'd be doing funding board, however, she was not able to be here because of the exam, so we move into the report of Student Development Committee, Chairperson Conway.
All right, hello everyone. I'd like to congratulate my two committee members for getting assigned to the Vice Chair Committee in the Sexual Harassment Program 1. Congrats, guys. Also, I'd also like to congratulate George Wang. like to give him a special shout out for student development because he's been doing a lot of work for us, reaching out to the cultural center, strengthening that relationship, and really taking a lot of steps towards getting the Coffee House to happen this year, which is like a non-competitive talent show that happened in the past by, it was Ozzy Cooley. He had done it a couple years ago and it kind of faded, but we're gonna bring it back, and George has really been doing a lot of work towards that. So I appreciate that. Keep it up. Next, we are also working on Celeron rebranding. We're gonna start with a pledge called These Hands Won't Harm. We're not sure where it's gonna be or how exactly it's gonna work. So surprise when that happens, but it's gonna be really cool. It's gonna be a big visual thing for all camps to see how important this issue is for students. And continuing work on rebranding. Also, Dominica, my vice chair, is going to be going to the foundation and start building a relationship with them. Start talking about different alumni events as well as collecting donations for the trail. Another thing is, some of you might have been looking this past Monday for the old megaphone on Fairwood Way. Sadly, that was pushed back 3 weeks when I went the Friday before. If you were wondering, event services need 3 weeks before you can plan an event. I was unaware of that. So that event will now be happening October 6th between 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. It'll still be the same plan I laid out for you guys in caucus. Just got pushed back a little bit. We'll be serving coffee, hot apple cider, and hot chocolate with little marshmallows. So please join us. Also, if you know any friends that might want to speak to USG or have any concerns about campus or want to say something nice, for the 1 hour where we are allowed to have amplified sound, I will have a megaphone out there. But for the rest of the time, it will just be a podium with this really cool sign I got. So that'll be exciting. Work towards traditions we did this week. We had a really great meeting on Monday with Spirit Pride Tradition, Student Alumni Association, Alumni Association, SUGOG, and some reps from Huskython to talk about what traditions are currently on campus, what programs are going on, how we can collaborate. And that was a really great moment, I think, for student government, because I got a lot of emails afterwards saying that they were thankful we brought them together, because even though I necessarily might not have found the projects I'm going to collaborate on, student government's here, we're a central location, and we're here to bring people together. This is great other collaboration, so that was really great to see. We also went to the homecoming meeting to see what's going on with that, to see if student... Danielle Bergman and Sarah Wozniak have been working on the poster campaign, which is going to be another sexual harassment prevention awareness thing going on. They found photographers for that, so keep an eye out for those. Regarding the rec center with Claire, I'm actually on the master planning committee, as well as I work at the rec center, and I'm going to be working closely with her. My committee will also be working if there's advocacy that needs that, so campus knows student voice. So if anyone's super interested in that or master planning, come find me, probably be in the office. So let me know if anyone's interested in that. And I think I'm gonna end with a fun fact for you guys. I found out while searching UConn history, there used to be a secret society in student government. Like, you know how Yale and all the Ivy Leagues have a secret society? There used to be one that was like six guys student government. They call themselves the Druids, and I decided that that's going to be the nickname for student development from now on. We're not going to talk about why that secret site was eventually kicked off campus, but that's not going to happen here, so, yeah, also, I don't know which one you let you guys in, get sent by committee, many addresses, so, Mondays at 6:30, that's all I have.
Are there any questions for the chairperson? Seeing none. Also, first, I want to add, I'm now creating a secret society, and somebody should join me here. That's awesome. All right, now we move into the report of the Student Services Committee, which is going to be given by Nicole Zhao, Senator Nicole Zhao of the School of Business.
All right, so Kaylee can't make it, but I'm going to give a quick update on what we're doing. So we've been splitting up into subcommittees for all of the things that all of our goals that we want to accomplish this semester. So I'll touch on a couple, dining and ticketing, student tickets for sports. So for dining, we hit on a few things, gluten-free options, the trays, and the napkins. So for gluten-free options, Kaylee has met with someone from dining, and she just wants to make sure to tell people that, all the people that you know that are gluten-free to register that they're gluten-free and to make sure that they let dining services know that they're gluten-free so that they can make sure that they have enough options, because I know that that's something that people are aware of or concerned with. With the trays, I know that South Dining Hall has taken away their trays, and they are doing this to save a lot of water. And I know that, I don't know if you guys have gotten emails that UConn is kind of lacking water right now. So that's one thing with the trays. And then for the napkins, I know there aren't napkins on the dining tables anymore in the dining halls. And that is because we are currently saving 336,000 napkins so far this start of the semester. So with that being said, that we are a very environmentally friendly university. Next with the ticketing, so one of the things that we were concerned with ticketing was having all the student tickets on your student ID, and I know there's been a lot of controversy on what was going to happen with basketball, and I believe all basketball tickets are going to be physical tickets, but we are talking about trying to change the way that they are on the student IDs and not have like the transfer fee and the printing services and all that stuff. But Kaylee has a meeting with the rep for tickets, so hopefully by next Senate she'll have more of an update on that.
Are there any questions for the standing chairs?
Yeah.
Please come up to the mic. Sorry. Gotta get everybody used to it.
I know, standing again. Not my thing either.
Presumably, you would ride the bus
classes every once in a while and teach the freshmen how great it is to be here and all the great chants, you would be asking me a lot of things. Like, it would be a big deal to be a tradition ambassador for the University of Connecticut. You could go to regional campuses and spread Spirit Pride tradition. You'd work closely with that office in general. So she wanted me to get senators' opinions on this because we are the voice of the student body. We're all very active here. Do you think that is something that would be beneficial to this campus, and do you think that would be something students would want to see?
Yes.
Anyone have any questions about this? Or
are there any questions? Chairperson Lynn.
Are you going to be looking for ideas on this structure thing that since look, Yellow Mental is putting together because academic affairs has a few ideas? Right? You were listening. So, would you like our idea?
That's another thing I talked about. I didn't forget you guys. I brought up the fountain in this meeting, and they are all for it. So, you're welcome. Student Development's just carrying the weight. I'm just kidding. No, we'll talk after. I talked to her about it, though, and they're very interested in working on it. And we will, Student Government as well, will be helping them set this up. So if anyone's interested in that specifically, we won't be running the program. It won't come out of us. But they do wish for our help to get student input and to have help organizing this new initiative. Second thing I'd like your opinion on while we're all here is new recreation center. Just quickly, because I'm going to be meeting with a couple people to talk about this. The original plan that we talked about last year, because a lot of you weren't here, was to have it up in Farmer Brown's lot, X lot. So if you live in like Hilltop, you know all those lots that are over up there, over there, which obviously you're probably like, oh, it's in the center of campus, but it also isn't the worst spot, especially if you see where dorms are going to be built in the future. And now the new plan, which we just found out about, which you'll get in greater detail next week, is going to be building it around the old. So you saw where they knocked down that building behind the old, current recreation center. They just started knocking it down. We're all walking to class. If anybody walks by that way, I know I do. It was a little inconvenient. So they want to wrap it behind and in front of the old facility. I just want some of your opinions on there. More than yes or no, like just let me know what you're thinking about that. Yeah, just give me a quick, just because I'm going to have to talk to a couple people about it, so I wouldn't want to go in with my own Danielle.
I just don't really need what you get in, like, rap or help.
So
I can't get you on.
Okay, so, like, yeah, I'm going to
The example that was given was Drexel. So if you want to look up Drexel Student Union, Student Gym, it's basically a way to disguise an old, uglier building, just if that's the words that we use. And it's going to be, it would come out right to the curb. Yeah, it's the same actually as what happened here at the Student Union. You can still see like the old wall of the Student Union. So it's the same.
Okay.
Oh, yes. Speak to workshop.
Is this new plan in any way like inferior to the original plan, or is it the same quality just in a different way?
So here's where the concern comes, because your first thought might be, well, that's good. They're going to revamp the old one. It'll still be in the center of campus, like right around the academic buildings. That's good. What the issue is with the current facility is it's literally falling apart. I'm a manager there, and the last time I closed, two light bulbs just fell from the ceiling. Don't really know why. The AC keeps breaking. For those of you who work out, knows how hot it's being. That building has been a consistent add-on for the past 40 years. They just do little add-ons here and there, and it's clearly still not the best facility available in public universities. Also, there's an issue with athletics, club sports, and just students who want to do recreation activities sharing the same space. That's been a concern. So what this new solution was going to be was give athletics and give club sports this current recreation facility, and this brand new one would be only for students. So you wouldn't have to worry about sharing the field with club sports. Club sports wouldn't have to struggle and go to Depot campus for practices. It was a big solution, and that is why we voted on XLOT. So now the concern is that they're just gonna do another extension, is that does problem of who's going to use what space. So does that answer your question a little bit about why it's a concern?
I believe Senator Puglisi was first.
With the old plan about how the new gym was going to be an X lot, what was UConn's solution to the parking? Because parking right now is currently very
awful.
So what would be the solution if we would get rid of X lot?
Yeah, I'll yield to you like that.
So what they were going to do, this wasn't finalized, like nothing was finalized, but this was the plan. An option was to build kind of like half underground, half above ground parking lot and have a playing field on top of it. They said that the same idea could be done here as well.
Thank you.
All right, I started a speakers list for all those who are unfamiliar with that region.
Isn't this what we're talking about next week at caucus?
Well, it is. So next week at caucus, you're going to be talking to Ed. But what I'm asking for is your opinions now as senators, because I have to go into meetings this week and I don't want to give my own personal opinion on the issue. So I'm asking for opinions of you guys while we're all here together. And then next week you're going to get the layout and you're going to get everything. I just need to know what your opinions are now before I go into the meeting.
Thanks.
Another concern about
the
parking is also a pedestrian thing. It's hard to maneuver around the campus and that. So if you build I've got to look at the facility more, but like the people that are coming down that I know now that I live in the last building, the whole apartment, it's a walk. So if my walk meant about like extended 10 minutes walking around the gym, that would take me about like 25 minutes to get to the center campus, and I would be very not okay with that. So just like a very, just like, I doubt it took a extra 10 minutes to do, but like it's nice having a cut through option, so just pedestrian thing would be.
No, that's like good stuff to hear, so.
Next was Natalie Vieira.
I'm just wondering, why did we move away from that soft plan? Like, why now?
So that is a great question, which I offer back to address.
Next is Theodore Terpstra.
Just to clarify, I know that the $450 fee was set on last year, but why is there still a $450 fee?
That's actually a really good question to bring up, is if we're just going to get rid of that word, then should the fee be lowered? I definitely bring that up to Bev. For now we are, I'd just like to clarify, we're not paying this fee currently, but I think next week when we do get this plan explained further on, I think that should be one of our concerns as well.
Next is Danielle Bergman.
While you're also losing money and energy losses.
anybody else who would like to be recognized for discussion? Ah, yes, William Coleman.
Thank you. Because right now, right now, I know how many I want, but I don't want to put that in there just in case, I need to add someone else. I don't want there to be a cap on it for this year, but we can go back and change that later. The bylaws are very flexible, so if we think that we need a cap, we can put a cap on there. If you want to amend it, amend the amendment. Depending on the number, I would take it as good. What number would you like?
how many people do you expect?
So right now, there are 8, including me, so 7.
Well, learning experience, right? To make a motion to amend the legislation, you can do that during the debate period. This was a great question exchange. So, once we go up for debate, you can go up to the podium and say, I motion to amend to say a 7 person or whatever number you so choose. Cap. All right. Is there anybody else who would like to be recognized for questions? Senator Ruckel.
Mr. Chair, is there anybody from or not from?
Yes, there's 2 people not from the student government. I'll just tell you who did that. Matt Murray from Subob and Sam Hollister from Confer.
Are there any other questions for the chairperson? Seeing none, we're moving to debate. Is there anybody who would like to be recognized for a debate on this motion? Senator Wang, go ahead and go up to the podium. And Kaylee sits.
Next year, say
only six people step up to the plate, you don't want to have to like rope somebody into it who doesn't really want to be there, or suddenly you have eight people who are super enthusiastic about it. I don't think that then you should be like, no, you can never be part of this. So I think that it would just be beneficial to maybe come up with a range or like a greater than or less than kind of thing. But I think an exact number would be pigeonholing is too much.
Next, Senator Berger.
I agree with Christina, however, this can just be changed next year, so there's not really an issue because that's what we're doing right now. So I don't really see that as the issue. I think the issue is that we just don't need to do this. It's just kind of an arbitrary number, and that's why we're getting ready for it, because it's just an arbitrary number. We don't need a number. If Senate feels uncomfortable with this, they can choose not to nominate 20 people if the next person to nominate 20 people. You don't need an arbitrary number, just leave it as it is. It's fine.
Next is Chairperson Conway. And Chairperson Hunt.
So, two things real quick. Just so you know, my nominations have to come back through Senate. So, next Senate, I will be nominating people. So, like, let's say you don't think I should have, let's say overnight I decided to have 20 people on the committee. When I come to Senate, you can cap me. Like, you have the power to cap my nominations, technically. So, if that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do, but I don't think we need a number in here. And also, the reason I don't want to specify a number is because I haven't set a meeting time, so I don't want the seven people that can do it now, like, to have that be the number, and then me either not be able to, I probably wouldn't be able to meet that if not everyone can make that meeting time. So, just for the sake of the order and to make it easier until I nominate, I think for now we should leave it.
Senator Ng, is there anybody else who would like to be recognized for debate? And now this is debate on the motion to amend. All right, is there anybody else who would like to be recognized? Seeing none, we move into a vote. And just so everybody's clear, it's not a vote on the entire legislation, it is a vote on the amendment. Oh, goodness.
My microphone. Yeah, so it is just on the number seven as a cap for members to order, for a number of members that have to be nominated. So, everybody clear on that? You are voting on the amendment to the legislation. All those in favor of enacting this amendment, please signify by saying aye. All opposed, please signify by saying nay.
Nay.
Any abstentions? So now we move back into the debate period on the legislation itself as is. Is there anybody else who would like to be recognized for debate on this legislation? Seeing none, we move into a vote. And all this is on the legislation itself. All those in favor of enacting an act concerning an amendment to the bylaws, not opposed, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, please signify by saying nay. Abstentions? Clearly passes.
Woo!
All right, next we move into announcements. Is there anybody who would like to be recognized for announcements? Senator Bergman, and then Senator Ron, and Chair Comptroller.
Hi everyone, this is kind of a PSA. The office has been really gross and dirty lately. The trashes have been overflowing and things have just been like left laying around. So just try to clean up after yourself. Find another trash can or something. And if you do put things on files on the computer and you don't need them anymore, try to delete those too. But yeah, that's it.
Comptroller Ron.
Accepting letters of intent for Deputy Comptroller until Monday 5 p.m.
description of responsibilities up on the USU website at 9 tomorrow morning. So anyone interested in that, look up that. I mean, the letter of intent is kind of just saying, hey, I'm applying, I'd be good for, because you should have me as your deputy, because I'll do this, because kind of thing. So not too long. That's all I got.
Next, Senator Myers.
Okay, hello everybody, almost done. I just wanted to talk to you guys about Bark for Beer. This is an event that's organized by my committee, the Promotion and Outreach Committee. It's going to be tentatively, but almost certainly held on October 10th, about 3 weeks from now. First shout out to Senator Alecha Khan. She's been an all-star on my committee so far, talking to late night to help plan this. It's going to coincide the same late night as Game of Thrones themed night. So if you have any ideas, please come to my committee. It's going to be held this Friday at 5 o'clock. We may be changing the time, but this week it will certainly be held on Friday at 5 o'clock. So if you want to come, talk to me about ideas, because this event is currently in the works and we're going to go through it. So that's it. Live the dream, write your verse, all this stuff. All right.
Next is President Price.
So Roma serves on the President's Library Advisory Committee, and she can't make the next two meetings. So if anyone is interested, they are October 23rd, which is a Thursday, and November 18th, which is a Tuesday, both from 12 to 2, and you get lunch. And this is the committee that we actually worked with about the hours and the 24/7 study space. So if that interests you, then please let me know so that we can send you as a replacement. It's with the Vice Provost for Libraries. Also, many of you brought up really great points about the gym, so be sure to really ask Bev all of those to make it and the whole committee think about it.
Next, Chairperson Lynn.
Earlier during my report, I mentioned that I'm still looking for a vice chair for advocacy. I have extended the due date for that to Monday the 29th at 4 p.m. Please have that letter in. You guys know what I'm looking for, the letter of intent. And pretty much it. Wish you guys a nice evening.
Vice President Romano.
Once again, if you're not on the listserv or on the website, come see Justin right after Senate and we can get all that set up. So we'll see Justin, everyone. We want everyone on the website and everybody to be on the listserv to get those emails.
Is there anybody else who would like to be recognized for announcements? I have one announcement. If you see an iPhone 4 or a pair of glasses, please contact me. They may or may not be under a bush somewhere, so please let me know. Anybody else would like to be recognized? Seeing none, we adjourn at 8:18.